handmade stuff.
Yes.
But what I wasn't finding was stuff handmade that was not a pipe.
Yes.
So it looks like an Amish harness maker that I met when I was shoeing horses. He does all the leather work.
Oh, very cool.
He does like women's purses, belts.
Very cool.
And I work with him and I work with customers and we design stuff together.
Oh, very cool.
This was designed an American composer. I met in April.
Oh.
Designed this with me. So it's, he wanted something that would be kind of like a briefcase.
Yes.
So it's got a strap for a laptop and everything, but it also has two loops for pipes. It's got a lighter holder. It's got a pouch in there for, it works well for a cell phone or for a tobacco pouch.
Very cool. So I like that there's a lot of different options. That looks like it's a tamper and a pipe holder. Nice. And you can definitely tell this is good quality leather. Very
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, I pick out the hides myself.
Oh, nice. Very cool.
And I also get those from an Amish supplier.
An Amish supplier. I like it. I like it. Which then tells me that it's going to be less chemicals in the meat than the... Well, the Amish are going to use, when they kill a cow for our hide, they're not just going to use the leather. They're going to use the meat. They're going to use everything that's part of it. It's going to be grass-fed. It's going to just be much better for the environment, too.
Yeah, they generally try to keep stuff as simple as they can.
Yeah, but they're definitely, like, people think, oh, the Amish, but it's like their way of life and farming is just so much more environmentally sound than a lot of other people. So people are like, oh, don't get into leather, beef, and stuff like that. It depends on how it's done. And I have to say, like, coming from a small farm town myself, it's the small farmers that are actually doing it the right way.
They're trying.
And it's so hard.
I couldn't stay in farming. I loved it. I would have.
So hard. And the corporations will...
They keep putting up our land taxes. But the thing is, we're not making any more money than we made 30, 40 years ago.
Yeah, and you're competing against a corporate farm that is going to have thousands of acres that is going to be milling out, you know, whatever they're...
And the problem with some of the hope for some of those guys is you are looking at, like, I mean, some of these, I know some of these guys, they mm-hmm. have what people consider now more of a factory farm, but they were on the verge of either
losing
the farm,
a farm
or they push capacity.
Yeah.
You can't afford a much land to graze all these cows. You can't do it.
Yeah.
Because you still, say you have a 400 cow herd.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can either get all those cows on, say, 100 acres,
mm-hmm.
and yeah, you got to keep them in the barn. Or they try to put fans on or they make it comfortable.
Yeah.
Or you can get another 100 acres to graze them on. Because people don't realize how much land a cow needs to graze if you don't put it out.
Yeah.
If you don't, it turns into mud. And that attracts flies and bacteria, viruses. People don't get that. But you add that extra 100 acres, now you're paying 100 acres more of land taxes
mm-hmm.
for the same amount of cattle.
Yes.
And there's nothing they can do about it. And now they've regulated head labor.
Yep.
So that was how farmers used to make it.
Yeah.
Teenagers would get jobs on farms, and they could learn, they could drive tractors. Now that stuff is so limited.
I remember as a kid, like, I would go to the farm, you know, and then clean out stalls.
Now we're basically, most places we can't do it.
Really?
We get in trouble so fast. And you figure what you pay an adult per hour. I mean, heck, my first job on a farm was like $2 an hour.
And you were happy.
Yeah. But the point is, we also had a blast.
Yeah.
We loved what we did.
Yeah.
But now I'm not allowed to do it. You have to do all this minimum wage and all this workman's comp.
Yeah.
You can't afford it. So the only way to do it is go to chemicals and equipment.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Or they go bust. And I had people, when I was on my grandfather's farm still, they would stop and yell at me about it. And I'm like, okay, well, when you go to the store, what kind of meat do you buy? Do you buy the USDA organic and all that? Well, no, that stuff's too expensive. We buy the cheap. It's like, you want the cheap? This is what you're going to get.
Yeah, exactly. And
if you don't buy the stuff, these farmers can't afford to do it.
Yeah.
You want us to farm that way? Pay what it costs for us to do it.
Exactly.
But the only people who've made more money in the past 30 years are the middlemen and the government, not us. Our prices are fixed. Milk prices are fixed.
Yeah. Doesn't the government, like, control some of that, too? I know that you do with the grain.
A lot of our stuff.
Yeah, very.
A lot of our stuff is very heavily government controlled.
Yeah. People don't realize that.
No.
And they think it's for the farmers' benefits.
And they get mad about these using seeds that are genetically modified and stuff. Well, the problem is, if we don't, we can't pay to afford to keep pests off and everything else. So you spray a pesticide and you get a GMO modified seed. It just doesn't attract the pests as much.
Yeah, yeah.
Or we go bloat and the farm turns into the next subdivision.
Yep. I don't know.
So it's people don't realize.
Yeah.
A lot. It's like, you know, that's all these things about animal stuff.
I am filming you. Can I post this? Okay. I always ask when it gets a little bit off topic. I'm just doing footage for the Pipe Show's website. But this is something that's close to my heart because I'm from a small town. Tillamook.
Okay.
Tillamook, Oregon.
Well, you just may want to cut it into two videos then, this part and then the Pipe Show.
I do this all the time because I find very interesting people at the Pipe Shows, you know?
They are. Generally, I find a really good group of people. And it's like if you walk away from your booth a minute, I don't come back and find stuff missing.
Yeah. Ah, it's very cool. Thank you very much. What was your name again?
I'm Jeremy.
Jeremy.